Okay, so it's been a while since I shot one of these videos, but in this short lesson, you're gonna learn how to write a song like J. Cole. Now, I understand this is a tall order. You're probably wondering, how am I gonna watch a YouTube video and magically create a song like one of the more talented, active, creative artists in the game right now? But if you just stick with me, I think you're gonna get a lot of good information in this short video that'll help improve you not only as a listener and a fan of rap music and J. Cole specifically, but you as a creative yourself, as a songwriter, and as somebody who wants to make your own impact and use the techniques that these great rappers are using. So without further ado, let's get into this. This is gonna be a lesson mainly based around the song G-O-M-D, Get Off My Dick by J. Cole. And the reason I use this is because it has a lot of the techniques and tactics that he uses over the course of his career to make catchy songs. And it's something that's sort of like your archetypal J. Cole song. It's your typical J. Cole song in a good way. And it has a lot of tactics that I'll mention other songs that he does this stuff in. But let's get into it. So the first thing in G-O-M-D that J. Cole does that leads to an effective song, something that's memorable, something that's exciting, is he breaks the song down with repeatable sections, catchy sections of the song that people can repeat. Now, when I'm explaining this, I'm not necessarily saying I'm homies with J. Cole and he told me this is how he did it, but these are things that you can identify for your own career that I've noticed. I myself have been rapping for 14 years and been coaching rappers from around the world for the last year. You know, so when I tell you these things as we go through this, these are things that I've noticed from my own expertise, but also I can pretty much guarantee this is the kind of stuff that these great MCs and great songwriters are doing. But what in G-O-M-D J. Cole is doing is breaking the song down into sections that aren't just I'm rapping at you, rap, rap, rap. Verse, 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 then a chorus, verse, 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 then a chorus. He's actually breaking it down into, here's a little catchy thing to start off. Here's a little intro that you can remember. Then I'm gonna rap for a while. Then I'm gonna have half of the chorus be something you might recognize. And then the other half will be something you can repeat and so forth. So let's get down to these examples. The song starts with a little bit of an intro, a catchy little line, you know, that you can kind of repeat with, you want to talk about it. This isn't actually the verse that you're listening to. It's actually just the intro, sort of like a beginning bridge or a call and response. So let's check this out. Listen to how this isn't actually the verse. It's just an introductory, catchy, repeatable section of the song.
You want to know just where I'm at? Well, let me tell you about it. I put my city on the map, but let me tell you about it. They try to say I can't come back, hey, let me tell you about it. Man, fuck them niggas, I come back, hey, let me tell you about it. I wanna tell you about it. Heads up, everybody run. Cole outside and he say he got a gun.
Okay, so you just listen to the intro of this song, and it's something you can get in the mood right before he breaks it down and starts actually spitting his verse. And you can use this yourself. Maybe instead of just going immediately into your full-on rapping verse, you can start with a little catchy thing. You know, want to talk about it. You know, break the song down into sections that people can sort of ease their way into the verse. And this is one tactic that J. Cole uses by having an intro. Now, along with having that intro and repeatable things along the way, you can think of something, for example, like, this is the part that the thugs skip. You know, that's not really a verse, it's not really a chorus, it's just a catchy thing that you remember and you can repeat when he's about to break it down. He also has the chorus in different sections. Now, of course, the chorus has the Lil Jon, the sort of homage to Lil Jon with the, you know, windows to the wall reference. And then it has another section, which is actually the breakdown, get off my dick, and then the beat rides. So let's listen to that and how the chorus has two different sections as well to make it more memorable, repeatable, and breaks it down.
I said to the window, to the wall, my nigga ride when I call, got bitches all in my mind. Niggas, I come home and I don't tell nobody. They getting temporary dough and I don't tell nobody. Lord, will you tell me if I changed? I won't tell nobody. I wanna go back to Jermaine, and I don't tell nobody.
This is the part that the thugs skip.
Young nigga never had love, you know, foot massage, back rub shit, blowing bubbles in the bathtub shit.
Okay, so you just listened to the chorus. Just like the beginning of the song where he has this catchy thing going on in the beginning, then the verse, he also has a catchy thing in the beginning of the chorus, happens to be in this case something from Lil Jon, and then the second half is the breakdown is something else to repeat. I mean, he's feeding you catchy things for you to repeat. So as you're going along, it's easy to remember. It's easy for large groups of people to repeat. And in other videos, I'll talk about this as well, where you want to envision things that thousands of people can say at once. You don't want to just write this song like it's just you by yourself in a room. So J. Cole is using these tactics. You should also check out as well songs like Power Trip, songs like Fire Squad. Now that you know that you can hear J. Cole is consciously as a writer making sections that you can repeat and you can sing along with thousands of people, you can listen to his career a lot more with a lot more noticing of the tactics he's using. So go check out Power Trip when, you know, go check out Tale of Two Cities where he's going,
last night they put up on my nigga at the light like, nice watch, run it. Hands in the air now, hands in the air, run it.
Notice how there, thousands of people can say that. It's catchy, it's easy to remember, and he's not necessarily writing the spit, 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 rap, 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 rap thing that many rappers do. Now the last thing that J. Cole does, along with breaking down the song into sections and repeatable phrases that you can find rather than just rap, rap, rap at the audience, but things they actually can repeat and thousands of people can say, is he also gives the beat time to breathe. Along with having things that are catchy and repeatable, you want to have times in which the audience can just breathe and not have to listen to rap, 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 rap. A lot of new rappers, because of the great talented MCs, the Eminems of the world, the Big Puns of the world, even J. Cole himself on some tracks, you might be sitting there thinking, every time I write a verse, I have to never take too many long breaks in between bars or rhymes, or I don't have to have the beat just play out for a while. But J. Cole in Get Off My Dick and other songs, and many rappers as well, if you think about Drake, Kendrick on his new album, they'll let the beat breathe. You might want to write 8 bars and just have a space, you know, have a breakdown. You can think about, for example, in Get Off My Dick, where there's that breakdown where the beat completely changes and then he raps the third verse. But in between, when that second verse, that second chorus ends and that third verse begins, there's a good 30 seconds of just music. So don't overwhelm your listeners. And that's another lesson you can get from J. Cole. You can find catchy, repeatable sections for your songs, find things that thousands of people can say, and you can also have time where the beat just breathes so the audience can just rock out with it as they do in Get Off My Dick. So, looking back, there's definitely 2 major things I want you to get out of this video. How to rap like J. Cole, how to write a song like J. Cole, and be sure to start listening after you watch this video to other J. Cole songs and noticing these tactics. Number 1, repeatable sections that are part of the song as well, not just verse, chorus, intros, breakdowns, little funny phrases. This is the part where the thugs skip. I mean, what is that? It's just a catchy phrase to keep you engaged. It's entertaining. And then on the other side is, let the beat breathe occasionally. You don't have to always over rap us. That's for the cypher. That's for the freestyle. That's for the party. Sometimes you want to have songs where the beat is just rocking, like in Get Off My Dick, and the audience can enjoy. So hopefully this helps. If you enjoy this, if you've never seen this before, How to Rap Drew. We are the number 1 rap coaching service in the world. Probably the only one right now that I know of. And check out howtorapdrew.com and be sure to sign up for our free newsletter. You can find it in the description box below. And a lot of cool free goodies on there and on the site, howtorapdrew.com. And thanks for listening. And comment. Tell me what you think of J. Cole's songwriting. Have you noticed any of this? And we'll talk soon. So with that being said, I'm Drew Marcy, and I just taught you how to rap. Peace.